25 million metric tons of CO2 emissions each year, mostly in what Beth Trask at the Environmental Defense Fund calls hard to decarbonize sectors of the economy.
That includes heavy industry like powering steel factories and producing the alternative fuels we'll need for long distance transportation. But we really have to get hydrogen right.
To that end, the hubs will use different strategies to make and use hydrogen. Alex Kaiser is with the Energy Futures Initiative Foundation.
The opportunity is when hydrogen is used, there are no greenhouse gas emissions released. And the challenge is how to produce hydrogen in low carbon ways.
And that challenge is a big one, says Sean O'Leary. He's a senior researcher at the Ohio River Valley Institute.
The hydrogen hub that's being announced for our region, the ARCH2 hub, is based on blue hydrogen,
a term used to refer to hydrogen produced from natural gas.
And so to that degree, you know, it represents a perpetuation and increased reliance on natural gas and fossil fuels.
The Biden administration says part of the new projects will be finding safe ways to capture and store CO2 emissions left over from making hydrogen this way. Min Khoi Lee is the global head of hydrogen research at Rystad Energy and says the scale of an experiment like this is unprecedented.
That is the biggest single fundings that we see governments around the world.
Coming up,
you know, we've regretted that in the aftermath.
Hindsight is always 2020, but first,
in the aftermath,
hindsight is always 2020, but first, let's do the numbers. All right, here you go on this Friday. The Dow up 39 points, a little over a tenth percent, 33,674. The blue chips. The Nasdaq subtracted 166 points. That's 1.25%, 13,407. The S&P 500 shrank 21 points, about 0.5%, 43.27. For the week, the Dow added 0.8%, the NASDAQ down 0.2%. The S&P 500 increased almost 0.5%. Checking in on those big banks that Matt Levin was telling us about. J.P. Morgan Chase added 1.5%. Wells Fargo pocketed 0.3%. Citigroup slipped about 0.25%. Boeing and its supplier Spirit AeroSystems announced they are expanding the scope of their investigation into quality control problems with parts for the 737 MAX 8 aircraft. Boeing descended 0.3%. Spirit AeroSystems Holdings dropped 1.6%. Bond prices were up. The yield on the 10-year Treasury note down 4.62%. To end the week, you're listening to Marketplace.
Marketplace is supported by C3 AI. C3 Generative AI provides chat GPT enterprise search that is verifiable, secure, and accurate across all enterprise data. Learn more at C3.AI. This is Enterprise AI.
Support for WNYC comes from Bases Independent Schools with campuses in Brooklyn and Manhattan. Learn more about their globally inspired